All right, you know our guest, Eazy-E from the critically acclaimed Straight Outta Compton, now part of another film. You're laughing when I say that. Jason Mitchell is here. Nice to have you.
Nice to be here, man.
I tell you what, was that the door opener?
That was the door opener. It definitely kicked the door open for me to unpeel my onion and show everybody, you know, really what I was made of. So it was nice.
I like that phrase, unpeel my onion. I think we put together about every movie you've been in, which is quite a few, Skull Island and all these different movies. But I think that's the thing. When Hollywood sees you can do it, then the opportunities start to happen a little.
Right, exactly. Because they're like, you know what? You're sort of an instant professional, and we don't want to pay you this much money if you're going to mess it up.
Right. That might have something to do with it. All right, you've seen the billboards all over town. This movie, Mudbound, is going to get an awful lot of attention. And what it's about, essentially, are black soldiers who fought in World War II, walking side by side with other soldiers, and then you come back to Mississippi and you're still treated like when you left.
Right, I just find myself behind enemy lines, which is crazy, you know, to go represent your country, go risk your life for your country, have a separate bloodline, have a separate latrine, have a separate everything, and then come home and you're still separated. You know, when over there you're a liberator, and it's a pretty wild ride.
We're going to show you a scene which is extraordinary, opposite Jonathan Banks. And, well, let me show it to you first, then we're going to talk about something that happened behind the scenes. Watch this.
Check it out.
You use the back door.
Go on, son. We don't want no trouble here. Go on. Go on.
You know what? You're absolutely right. When we was overseas, they didn't make us use the back door. General Patton put us on the front line. Yes, sir. And you know what we did? We kicked the hell out of Hitler and them Jerrys. Are y'all at home safe and sound?
Now, the intensity of your interaction with Jonathan Banks is such, at one point he yells out, of course, the N-word. He said he had trouble doing that scene. Terrible.
He did. He actually stopped the scene at one time with, like, tears welling up in his eyes, being like, how many more times do we have to do this? Like, I can't keep doing this. And he was always a really big supporter of me. They have some scenes that are more intense than that, and on those days, they were very hard for him. You know, I came back to the hotel, and he's just sitting at the bar by himself. Aww. Like, you just did something really great. You just did something really stand up, you know? And it's nice to have that sort of support from the team, because in order to make a movie like this, you have to have unity, you know. So
and I tell you what, the woman behind the camera is a filmmaker you may or may not know named Dee Reese. I met her during the press junket. I was unbelievably impressed by her. She was impressed by you.
Yeah, it was amazing, because this was the first lead role I had ever been offered in my life. And Dee literally calls me up and was like, you were the first person on my wish list. You have to attach yourself to this. And I was the first person casted.
And some of your colleagues, Garrett said this to me at the junket, that this is the, I mean, you know, people throw these things around, that she's the next Spielberg, that she's the most formidable director.
She definitely is. Sorry, Mom, but she's the most sure black woman I've ever met in my life. Like,
what makes
she
you
knows
say that?
Exactly what she wants, and she knows how to get it. And when you shoot a film like this in 29 days, like, and you kill it every day. Like, we shot an entire war scene before lunch. Wow. You know what I mean? Like, she knows exactly what she wants, and she knows film, and she's passionate. So, you know, with those things, like, you can't miss the mark.
And Granddad's a Korean War veteran.
Yes.
87, and you took him to the premiere.
Yes, I did. And it was a great moment for me. It was very nice, because I don't even think that, like, because all he wanted to do was bring his children to LSU and put his children through college, because all black people could do then was pick up trash when he was young. So he was like, I want to, you know, send my kids to LSU. And now I'm on TV, and now I get to tell his story. And it's like, it goes so far. Like, I took field trips to these places that I shot at.
Sure.
You know what I mean? When I was young. So it's so cool to, like, actually have this go full circle.
Mudbound is going to get much and more attention. It is on Netflix streaming now. It's also in theaters across the country. Comes out on Friday. Really good to see you.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
It's amazing.
There it is.
Great to see you.